Oh, smack bang! The king is here!
On the 24th of September at One Revolution, a Goliath meets a giant slayer in a bout for the ages. One lightweight world champion, Christian Lee, defends his belt against a surging Ok Rae Yoon.
그 저도 똑같이 그 이름값에 걸맞는 이제 명성이 생기는 것 같아가지고 저도 엄청 좋게 생각하고 있는데 레전드 킬러라는 그런 명칭을 제가 받은 거에 자체도 엄청 그 좋은 선수들 이겼기 때문에 제가 그런 거를 받아서 좋긴 한데 이제는 뭐 제가 또 레전드가 될 수 있도록 이제 할 수 있게 이제 다른 좋은 경기를 많이 펼치겠습니다.
I have cleared out most of the division. The only guy in the top 5 I haven't fought yet is Ok Rae Yoon. He's definitely done a great job earning himself the title shot.
Christian Lee has been on a tear since moving up to lightweight. He is undefeated in 6 bouts with 5 finishes and also won the One Lightweight World Grand Prix. Lee rules what many consider the toughest weight class with ruthless efficiency.
When I first started my journey in the lightweight division, it was right away a title shot. So I already had plans to become the champion and to remain the champion. I did envision everything happening the way it did, but I'm definitely grateful that the plan that I had laid out and the plan that I saw was able to come true.
Christian Lee is not just the greatest lightweight, but Christian Lee has the most knockouts, he has the most wins, and he has the most finishes in all of ONE history. Christian Lee gets it done each and every time. It's truly made him not just a phenomenon, but a supernova inside ONE Championship.
I do think that the style that I possess is a very tough one to prepare for. I'm well versed in all ranges of mixed martial arts. It's really going to take a lot for somebody to come in here and to beat me in any specific area, let alone every area as a whole. Although there's many hungry contenders working their way up, I will continue to stay one step ahead.
Christian Lee from phenom to world champion. The boy wonder continues to rule the ONE lightweight division with an iron fist.
I definitely feel that after I defend my title for the 3rd time, I will be the greatest lightweight in ONE Championship history. I already feel that I'm the best lightweight in the world, and defending my title one more time is just going to help validate that.
His opponent, Ok Rae Yoon, has been making waves of his own. He arrived at ONE Championship with little fanfare, but the South Korean has set about making himself known to the division.
ONE Championship 오기 전에는 제가 한 15경기 넘게 경기를 했었음에도 불구하고 그렇게 유명한 선수가 아니었어요. 그래도 저는 이제 좋은 무대에 가서 좋은 경기를 펼치면 언제든지 제가 뭐 이름을 알리고 그리고 또 명성이 좀 더 높아질 수 있다는 그런 확신이 있었기 때문에 뭐 이번 ONE Championship에서는 좋은 기회가 생겼고 그 무대가 만들어졌기 때문에
Ok Rae Yoon, this guy has looked so impressive each and every time. The thing is, he's been able to do these types of performances on short notice. Nobody has had such a quick ascent to the top as Ok Rae Yoon has had.
He debuted against former ONE featherweight world champion Murat Gafarov and showed no signs of nerves. Showing toughness, he shut down the Russian to get the win. But the match that made his name was his fight with former UFC and Bellator world champion Eddie Alvarez.
언젠가는 한 번은 붙어보고 싶다는 이런 선수였는데 기회가 이렇게 빨리 올 줄은 사실 몰랐어요. 마락 가프로프 선수와 경기를 하고 나서도 부상이 그렇게 크게 큰 부상이 있지 않아서 다행히 뭐 좋은 기회라 생각하고 에디 알바레즈 선수와 경기를 하기로 마음먹었습니다. 네.
This is the biggest match in Ok Rae Yoon's career. A fight with a legend, an icon, a giant of mixed martial arts, Eddie Alvarez. Can he seize the moment?
Back to the lead leg of Alvarez. You were talking
about those smack! The big kibosh! The big kibosh! Ok Rae Yoon's got Eddie in trouble!
Ok putting Eddie down and then jumping all over him, trying to empty the gas tank, going after the finish with the hammer fist.
What an upset! Ok Rae Yoon beats Eddie Alvarez. This will send shockwaves around the martial arts world.
Once the two of them squared off, I had my eyes on Ok. Anytime there's a new contender in the lightweight division, automatically I take notice. So I was watching that match.
Ok Rae Yoon will now face Christian Lee for a shot at the one lightweight crown.
It's a huge opportunity that is right in front of him. All he has to do is reach out and grab it. But to do that, he has to dispatch one of the most dominant champions one championship has ever known.
뭐 마르크 카프로프 선수, 에디 알바리 선수는 레전드고 엄청 강한 선수들이기 때문에 뭐 당연히 뭐 더 강한 상대와 붙어야 된다고 지금 생각을 하고 있었고 이번에 크리스찬 리 선수와의 경기도 꼭 준비를 잘 해가지고 제가 뭐
The reason he's found so much success is because he's a taller fighter in the lightweight division, so he's able to outreach and outmove many of his competitors. So when I go in there, I'll be looking to cut off the cage and to eliminate his use of his footwork.
뭐 크리스찬 리 선수도 그래플러 성향이 강한 선수예요. 그래서 제가 또 그래플러인 선수와의 상성이 아주 좋고 뭐 기술들은 앞선 이제 마르크 카프로프 선수나 아니면 에디 알바레즈 선수와의 경기에서 제가 또 많이 학습되고 준비가 많이 되었기 때문에
If Ok wants to stop my takedowns, I will just strike with him. And if he wants to strike with me, then I'll take him down. I'll have an answer for everything he throws at me.
크리스찬 리 선수가 이제 역대 라이트급 최강이라는 타이틀을 갖고 싶어 하는데 근데 그거는 이제 저를 만나기 전에 그런 칭호를 얻었을 뿐인 거고 아마 그런 욕심은 이번 시합에서 이제 내려놓고 이제 저한테 타이틀을 반납하시고
I see this matchup ending in the first round. I'm going to take Ok down and I'm going to submit him.
크리스찬 리 선수의 모든 테이크다운을 방어해내고 2라운드 안에 KO를 시키고 타이틀 벨트를 제가 챙겨서 집에 가겠습니다. I'm here to stay.